Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello students, in this video we'll discuss about how to find the angular momentum of a rigid body which is rotating. That is in case of a rotation, how to find the angular momentum. So let us see. Students, let us see how to find the angular momentum of a rigid body in rotation. That means only rotation is there, no translation motion is there. So let us consider any rigid body, like see, any arbitrary shaped rigid body, and suppose that this is the axis of rotation. So it might be a three-dimensional object or two-dimensional object or any type of arbitrary shaped object. Now suppose that the object is rotating with angular velocity omega, which is constant. So it is the omega is not changing with time, it is constant. So alpha is 0, that implies obviously that alpha is 0, the angular acceleration will be 0. When the angular acceleration is 0, the quantity omega is constant. So when the object is rotating, each point on the object of which it is made up of will also have the same value of omega. That we have already discussed, that every particle on a rigid body will have same omega but will have a different linear velocity. This particle will, when this body rotates, this particle will move in a circle. This particle also move in a particular circle, and so on and so forth. Okay, now when it is like, let us first write the basic idea about the diagram that we used to do. That is, let us consider a rigid body consisting of n number of particles . This is suppose particle 1 and its mass is m1. This is suppose particle 2 and its mass is m2, and this is the last particle, nth particle, mass is mn particles, and they are at distances r1, r2 and rn from the axis of rotation, particles situated respectively . So we'll consider that the rigid body is made up of n number of particles of masses m1, m2, mn, and they are present at a distance r1, r2 and rn respectively from the axis of rotation, and this rigid body is rotating with the angular velocity omega. Now to find the angular momentum of the rigid body, to find the angular momentum of the rigid body, The basic idea is to find the angular momentum of each particles and add up vectorially in terms of vector. You have to add because angular momentum is a vector quantity. So if I have a particle like m1 here, and it is at a distance r1 from the axis of rotation, and it is rotating with omega, this particle will move in a circle. This particle will move in a circle, and because omega is constant, so the v1 value also will be constant. The tangent drawn is the linear velocity that will remain constant, and we know that linear velocity v1 is omega into r1. This is from circular motion. Now, the basic definition of a formula for angular momentum L is r cross p. This is the general expression. This is the cross product of two vectors. One is the position vector, another is the momentum, linear momentum. So angular momentum L is also known as moment of momentum. So this, if I put this value, if I use this general formula for this case, the L1 value, because this is the first particle, the L1 value will be R1 cross P1 vector. R1 is this distance in terms of vector. As this is rotating like that in anticlockwise sense, I consider the object somewhere something like that, and it is rotating about this axis. So all the particles will have angular momentum pointing in this direction along the axis. So if I consider this is x-axis, this is y-axis, so it will be vertically up, that is along k-cap direction. So it is k-cap direction or along z-axis or along the axis in this direction. This is the direction of L vector for all the particles. They will have different value of magnitude will be different, but the direction is same. So I want to find the magnitude part, so it will be L1. Because direction I know that it will be in this direction, so only I'll concentrate on the magnitude of the angular momentum, which comes out to be r1 p1 sine theta. This is the magnitude part of the cross product, which is ab sine theta. Theta is the angle between these two vectors. Radius vector, when a body rotates in a circle, the radius vector and the linear velocity makes an angle of 90 degrees. Always, at any position, this always makes an angle 90 degrees, whether the particle is here or here. The linear velocity vector will always be perpendicular to the radius vector. If it is so, theta is always 90, so the whole of this sine theta becomes 1. So this is left with R1 is R, L1 is R1 and P1, P is mb. We know that linear momentum formula is m into v. So in this case, the particle is having mass m1, so it is m1, and the velocity is your v1, so mv1. So mbr, that is m1, r1, v1. And this is the angular momentum, magnitude of the angular momentum for the first particle. And because v1 is omega r1, I will substitute here, so I will get, so L1, which is angular momentum of the first particle, comes out to be m1, v1, r1. Because v1 is omega r1, I substitute this value over there in this expression. So I'll get this is m1 omega r1 into r1. So in place of v1, I have written omega r1 from here. Okay. So now this comes out to be m1 r1 square omega. This is the magnitude of angular momentum of first particle about the given axis of rotation. Axis of rotation. Because direction is along the axis and up. Similarly, if I continue like that, the L2 value, that is the angular momentum for the second particle. This is a first particle. And for second particle, the angular momentum will be here, it will be m2 r2 square, omega will remain same for all the particles, that is constant. If I proceed like that, the last particle I will have is ln, this is for nth particle, which will have angular momentum mn rn square omega. Because I have already considered the direction of the body in this direction, all the direction of L will be in this direction. So each particle, the direction is that way only. So because all the vectors are in the same directions, so when you add, then you can add in terms of algebra. Algebraically, just you can add as we add two numbers. So the angular momentum of the whole rigid body L is given by up to ln. I've just add all the angular momentum contribution by each and every particles. When you add them, you'll get the angular momentum of the rigid body. That is our n. So the angular momentum of the rigid body is L1 plus L2 and up to Ln. By substituting the value of L1 that I found, that is M1 R1 square omega. For second particle, it is M2 R2 square omega and so on. Last one is Mn Rn square omega. From here, if I take omega common, it is M1 R1 square plus m2 r2 square and so on up to the last particle mn rn square. This is very simple. From these terms, I have considered this omega out common, and this is left with the value. Now this term already we are acquainted with. This is the sum of all the value of I varies from 1 to n. And this is mi ri power 2. The meaning of this is that when you put I is 1 here, this is m1 r1 square, that will give you the first term. When you put I equals to 2, it is m2 r2 square, that will give you the second term. And the last term is this one, when you put I is equal to n, you will get this term. This sign means is a summation. So when you get all the terms, you add them. This is the addition of all the terms. So this whole thing in the bracket stands for the moment of inertia of a rigid body I, that we have already discussed. So finally, we are getting that I L is I omega. This is the final expression for angular momentum of a rigid body in pure rotation. And the body is rotating only, and there is no translational motion, the angular momentum comes out to be this. So this is the final expression for the angular momentum of a rigid body. Okay, thank you.